intention with this reading is to empower you with gentle, supportive guidance, and to use ASMR to help rewire your brain to this state of empowerment. When your brain is in an alpha or a theta state, you're more connected to your subconscious, to your intuition. Also have justice. So right off the bat, I'm seeing that some of you are finding yourself feeling like you've sacrificed a lot and your hands are tied. You may feel like you are in some sort of waiting period. This is sometimes known as an incubation period, a time where action is not, a time that is not suited best for action, but rather waiting. Seeing the world in a different way, maybe 180 degrees different than how you've seen it before, and it's allowing you to expand your consciousness. You're being exposed to new ideas, new ways of thinking, and it's changing you. It's making you blossom in certain ways. You're blossoming into the next version of yourself. You feel torn, like other people or helping other people. You feel like other people are dependent on you in some way, in a way that keeps you from fully committing to your own transformation or your own metamorphosis. Others of you, you actually have a benefactor, you have some mentor who is facilitating this experience. This person, you're on the receiving end of their blessings and of their charity and their generosity, and it's allowing you to finally blossom into the butterfly that you always knew you could become. I think for many of you, of giving and receiving in your life right now is actually exactly what it should be. Whether that includes challenge or it's making it easier, there's something about the balance between giving and receiving in your life that is either compelling you to change, it's compelling you to transform by offering resistance. It's making you, it's giving you a conflict that you can rise above, and it's a motivator. Or it feels easy, it feels supportive at this time. Either way, this balance of giving and receiving is exactly the symbiotic relationship . Things don't have to be identical in order for them to be equal. You may be in a receiving time in your life right now, or a giving time, and while it may feel extreme in that way, it's actually balancing out. It's balancing that out, considering your entire past and the future. This balance looks like, because in the micro view, it may look like imbalance, it may look like extremity in some way. Spirit, give us more words, please. Off of a time of incredibly hard work, of perseverance, and so you've, in a way, you've done all you can do to a certain degree in some area of your life. And this isn't about micromanaging things any further. At this point in the journey, at this point in the long-term view, in this, in your investment in some long-term goal, your next step is surrender. Your next and current step is surrender. It's surrendering. Surrendering or letting go is actually the process, part of the process of persevering for you. It's very counterintuitive. action of surrendering, which may look like nothing on the outside. Remember that it may be your ego that is the cloud of judgment, because in some way this is not meeting the ego's expectation of what your journey, what you thought your journey would look like. Surrender in general, letting go, hanged man energy, is very difficult. It's very challenging for the ego specifically. So the conscious mind right now for you may feel crazy, like you feel like it's hard for you to access mental clarity, it's hard for you to feel certain about an idea. You may even be rethinking a specific idea, but you also could just be experiencing very clouded judgment because your ego may feel at odds with the justice. There's an instinctual moral compass within you that's operating in full gear right now and is perhaps in the driver's seat for many of you. And that might not be clear to you, since the action that you're taking is non-action. Since it's an action of surrendering, it's a passive action. There is something about this that is completely right, and your higher self knows this, your subconscious knows this, your intuition knows this. There is justice, there is fairness, there is truth, there's cause and effect, there is law. In the waiting time and incubation time, lives to so much more than just this one singular experience. I'm seeing a healing with your relationship with higher power, a healing with yourself, a deep inner healing with yourself, a healing with your desires and goals and dreams, almost like making peace with them. If you have felt at odds, if you have felt as if you've been fighting them all your life, fighting for them and then tearing yourself down at the same time, this is a making peace, a peacemaking with those dreams, so that you actually can give yourself a chance to make them happen. I say that too because Page of Cups is in a potential near future, indicating that there are creative opportunities coming to you, intuitive messages, curiosity, possibility, all coming from a place of emotional renewal, enlightenment, and fulfillment. Kind of like a sudden lightheartedness about life. And maybe it's because there's discovery, maybe it's because you meet someone or something that makes your heart full again and puts you in that place of falling in love, which is a great energy to be in. It affects everything else in our lives in a positive way. So if you're able to feel this way about any one thing in your life, it bleeds into these other areas, strengthening you, filling your cup in so many different categories. And ultimately restoring faith and hope about the bigger things in life as well. When we can feel good about small things on a regular basis, we start to feel better about the bigger things too. And it's feeling better about those bigger things that help us realize those bigger things, help us actualize those bigger things, and bring those bigger things from the unseen into our seen experience. There's also an energy in your environment, a somewhat rebellious energy with the guru or your event in reverse, that indicates a kind of pushing back against dogma, a pushing back against beliefs, old beliefs, old ways of doing things, or even just groupthink in general, like doing something because everyone around you is doing it, or doing things for the sake of belonging. Maybe you're seeing examples of other people in your life no longer choosing, making these decisions from a place of tribal, wanting to belong in the tribe. And that is inspiring you to do the same thing for yourself, to make decisions that are rooted in or guided by your moral compass, and also by the greatest dream that you have, that you hope and pray come true. Personal beliefs of people around you changing, which also is affecting your personal beliefs changing. I'm seeing a sense of freedom and a challenging of the status quo. This is a time when it is safe to do that. It is not only safe to do that, but it's important for you to do that if that feels right to you. If, and I say the word right as in really right, if it feels just challenging the status quo. The universe is supporting that energy in you right now. The universe is supporting your freedom to think for yourself and choose a different path for yourself. some of you push back against people in authority positions, question people in authority positions, but also question people in positions that you hold authority over for others of you. And challenge the status quo of some of these symbiotic relationships. Just because they are symbiotic and just because they work doesn't mean that they're sustainable forever or that you need to sustain them forever. In fact, like most things, they have an end point, they have a natural end. And yours may be nearing in certain ways a natural endings with such people in your lives, or endings of such power dynamics in certain relationships in your life, maybe ending along with the end of this incubation period. When the time feels right, you may act in a way that completely changes the power dynamic between you and someone else. What is needed, though, in order to do that, the biggest piece of advice for you, is a reorganization of your priorities. Two of Pentacles, we have an advice which tells us that it's important for you more than ever that you don't juggle around commitments just for the sake of juggling, but instead you adapt to what is the most important to you right now. Say no to things that you don't want to commit to, and prioritize the things that are most important to you. Recommit to those things that are most important to you. It's very important that you manage your time well right now, even though it seems like you have all the time in the world and this hanged man time. Even though it seems like you're just waiting for something to happen to you, or you're just waiting for the other shoe to drop. That's an illusion of sorts. Like I was saying before, you're not doing nothing. Just because there's no outside action that you're taking, a lot is happening within you in this time. And it's more important than ever that you are observant and you look through these lenses that are available to you in this position of discomfort, in this position that's very different from how you normally see the world. You allow that to inform your beliefs, inform your opinions. If they take you away from conventional opinion, conventional belief, so be it. That's a good sign that you may be on the right track. And that you allow these observations, allow these pieces that add, that ultimately will create your ultimate enlightenment at the end of this incubation time, that will fuel you into action. It's important you take these things and allow them to reorganize you on the inside, to reorganize your values, your beliefs, your goals, your dreams. Everything that you care about, and also to devalue the things that you don't, that you may still be carrying around, juggling with yourself. It's not necessary to juggle the things that you don't want to prioritize at all, but perhaps there are things that you feel rather attached to, that the ego has been attached to for a while. Which is why the ego is so confused right now. But that Ace of Swords in reverse, it's why the ego is rethinking an idea or a decision and questioning things that the ego perhaps already decided on in the past. It's good that you're rethinking things. Hopes and fears. The Page of Swords. Meaning that your greatest hope and your greatest fear is self-expression. True, honest self-expression. The kind of self-expression. hope and it's the fear in this situation. There's also a hope, you know, a fear of being all talk and no action. But if you're able to really trust that when it's the right time to act, when you have, you've gathered all the information, you'll be able to act appropriately. You'll know the best path of action for you once you have all the information, which is the end of this hanged man period. Then you have nothing to worry about. All you need to do is trust that when you have what you need, you will be able to take action. And until then, all the action that you are taking is action that only happens inside. And that's not enough.